I welcome Roberto Roman, Associated Professor at the Faculty of Physics and Mathematics, Mathematical Science at the University of Chile. And you are board member of ISINS. You came across the ocean to visit this European conference. What are your impressions?
It's been a very wonderful morning. I assisted to the plenary sessions and oral sessions, and the things I already heard and the new conferences I plan to attend means it's going to be a very productive week.
Excellent. Chile, I think, is a very prospering future market in photovoltaics. What are the drivers in your country?
It's, I think, first of all, we need to move from fossil fuels to renewable energy, of which we have a lot, especially solar energy. And this has been understood after many, many years of work. Today, solar electricity accounts for over 1,000 megawatts of power, and it's going up online faster. Renewable energy already accounts for over 20% of total electrical production, and in 2006, it was less than 10%. So it's going up quite quickly. And there's also lots of opportunity in other sectors, in process heat and so forth.
So you here in this conference, the building sector and industry, as you said, are the focus points. So you see also renewable heat as a chance for Chile?
Yes, we already have quite a few projects. One of the biggest ones is in Minera Gabriela Mistral. It was designed by Energía Yaima, and it provides about 80% of the heat for electrowinning copper, which is a total production of about 400,000 tons a year from solar energy. And that's been in operation for over 3 years now. And it's a project I've been involved in as a consultant for Codelco with the Energy Center at the University of Chile.
I think it's the largest operating plant within solar heating and cooling worldwide. It's a very case study. So are there other mines having interest in using solar heat in Chile?
Yes, they are, but they, at the moment they're sort of holding back because since the price of copper has gone down, they're not as open to investment as they are, even though the investment would be done by the company, but they don't want to sign long-term contracts. So this whole thing is being reviewed so to see how we can lower the cost of solar thermal heat, and it's possible. It's possible to lower it to cost that will be truly competitive, even with the low price of oil and other fossil fuels.
So you supported ISIS as board member, and you have been vice president of membership affairs. What is your special for ISIS in your region? How can ISIS support your processes in Chile and elsewhere?
I think in many ways. First of all, with the contacts. Through ISIS, I've met many wonderful people, and the contacts has helped me immeasurably to promote the use of solar in Chile. As you know, ISIS is the leading society as regards solar energy worldwide. I mean, almost all the great pioneers have been ISIS members since its founding, and I think it's 1954. I've been a member for quite a few years now, and always I find that it's easy to network, and it's easy to find people that help you to promote your ideas and give you good ideas also.
Okay, so I wish you an excellent conference. Thanks for the interview.
Thank you.